We first studied all the code that has been written on Flight Simulator, Flight Simulator X. There's been many years of work on all the code base, and the code base of the simulation of the aerodynamics was pretty huge. So the system now supports sloped surfaces, which means that aircraft can land on sloped runways, but also on any slope in the world. Aircraft can now land on a sloped field. For example, if you want to simulate an engine failure, you can make a cross-country landing on any surface, including sloped surfaces like fields on mountain slopes. It's gonna work, and the way the brakes are simulated, so this allows for planes to come to a full stop even on slopes and turn around and take off again. We also rewrote the integration system of the simulation. So the integrator is what makes the simulation go forward. It calculates all the states of the system. So one thing we changed is now that the simulation is running at a much higher frame rate, but the frame rate is adaptive, so it adapts to the frame rate of your actual TV or monitor. This means that the simulation is much more smooth. Whatever the frame rate of your display, even if you have slower frame rates, frames are exactly going to match the display. And also the simulation is always going to run at a higher frame rate. So even if your frame rate goes down, the simulation stays at a high frame rate and you don't lose anything of the realism. Planes always behave as they should, whatever the... We improve the way flaps can be set in the files, which allows to have more control. We finally reworked the way gears and external parts like external tanks are simulated. Instead of just hard coding the moment they apply on the aircraft, they are actually physical elements in the airflow, which are attached to the airframe outside of the aircraft. And they now are realistically simulated aerodynamically, just like the aircraft, and by clouds, by mountains, by buildings, by the shape of the world, right? I hope you enjoyed the details I gave about the simulation, about what we changed.
I own the different sources of light, and to render all of them all together, typically the sunlight, the moonlight, the starlight, the city lights, all of those things are informed by the air density, by the humidity of the air, even sometimes by the pollution. And all those different layers of atmosphere are taken in account to scatter all the photons coming from those different light sources. So the shadows have also been really improved. Now the mountain casts shadow on the clouds, the clouds cast shadow on the mountains, the clouds cast shadow on themselves, and all of those different layers of clouds cast shadow on the ground, which gives a general feeling of realism which is never seen before. We've got now a fully volumetric 3D rain natively in the game. We also have a volumetric rainbow scattering. It's really based on what would happen in real life if you have the right context, the right level of humidity, typically rain. So the rain impacts also the cockpit itself. Each water drop on the windshield is informed by the speed of the plane or the thrust of the engine. Depending on this, you will see each drop of water being stretched on the windshield, which is pretty neat. We also have a fully volumetric fog. We also have the icing, depending on the real-life parameters and context. So we will see the ice propagating on the wing, and with all the systems that allows the pilot to de-ice the wing. This clip is cool because it shows what I was talking about. You can see this cloud in the middle of the picture, which is lit directly by the sun because there is a hole in the cloud sailing, and the other clouds all around are darker. And it works also for the rain that you can see under the cloud, which is lit directly by the sun too. So here you can see the rain impact the cockpit rendering, and typically the way the water propagates on the windshield itself. And you can see that depending on the speed, the drop of water will be stretched in the direction of the wind, which is pretty neat. Yearly based day and night cycle. What it means is that the position of the sun will be really informed by the moment of the year. Summer, the sun will be higher in the atmosphere in the north hemisphere, obviously. And it will be lower during the winter. But it's the same thing for the position of the moon, depending on the moment of the year or the month. Same thing for the stars, which will have their accurate position in the sky. We have also completely revamped the lights on the ground. So the city lights, the road lights, the runway lights, or the airport lights in general, all those lights will also inform the rendering. You can see the clouds being lit by the city by night. And it allows, as a result, VFR navigation by night, which is pretty cool. All the reflection also are taken in account. So you will see all those lights reflect on the water, for example. which is also rendered as any layer of the atmosphere. It sounds weird, but it's actually the case. So you can see on those videos that during a dark day, the water will be super dark and the reflection of the buildings are really dark. And in a bright day, you can see that suddenly, the Seattle Bay is pretty colorful, and you can see that the ocean now is at the same spot, much more blue due to the color of the sky and the reflection of the building themselves. It's much more colorful too. On this one, you can see how the updraft informed the formation of this storm. As a result, now I would like to show you this video where we can see the different type of preset we've got in the game. You can change them on the fly from clear sky to broken sky to stormy weather to rain, etc. All those presets are accessible directly from the in-game interface. So I would like to show you now something pretty cool that you haven't seen before, is the ability for the user to change seamlessly the time of the day just with this slider. It's real time, no loading, and it's really cool. Hope you enjoyed it. Based on everything I've said so far on the weather system, the architecture of the rendering of the weather has been made in order to also be able to receive real-world data and to inject those data directly in the engine to represent the real world as close as the data we actually collect all around the world. Those data are somewhere around 60 different layers everywhere in the world. Each of those layers, again, define the level of humidity, density, fuzziness of the different clouds type. We inject that directly in the engine, and it gives us as a result exactly what we would observe in real life.
So when we started working on Microsoft Flight Simulator, that was at the same time scary and super exciting, because there are so many things to do. I will talk about one of the biggest things that we had to do, and this is a key feature for flight simulators, that is the world. It is full of natural wonders, from Ayers Rock to the Himalayan mountains, to also man-made features like the Statue of Liberty, Mont Saint-Michel, the Tour Eiffel. So when we started doing this, we realized how much the world is big. The world is really big, and to the point that we even had to change the internal way we represent a 3D point in space in our engine, like from single precision floating point to double precision floating point, because we couldn't handle that big of a world. And the biggest impact of this was on the amount of data, because you need a lot of data to represent the world. Luckily enough, Bing Maps was here with 2 petabytes of aerial imagery, elevation data, 3D scans for a select number of cities. So all of this data were there sitting ready for us to stream in the simulator. This allowed us to get all the airports in the world, which we estimate to more than 40,000, to get all the cities across the world, which we estimate to more than 2 million, to get all the roads in the world, to get all the mountains in the world. Basically, the entire world is there available for you to fly. Not only do you have the entire world, but it also matches the real world, is that now VFR flying is available for you everywhere. So for those of you that don't know what VFR means, it means visual flight rules, and it's a way of flying your aircraft by relying on visual cues in the environment, like where you see a given city or a given river. So for example, when in real life we do some piloting, and when in the DR400 we can see the Garonne River here and the city of Martillac there, we can deduce where we're going. The amazing thing is that now we can recreate this very experience right inside the simulator. So I encourage you, once you get the chance to try it, to fly over your house. We needed really more data than that. The reason we needed those data is because we still didn't know where to place trees. We still didn't know what shape a building should have, and what color its roof should be, what is the type of roof over there. This is an island in near New Guinea. If we only had Bing Maps data there, the island would be kind of flat and you wouldn't have the trees and the buildings. So thanks to the detection that we could run on Azure,
We know where to place trees, we know where to place buildings, we know what the building should look like, and this allows us to create a much more believable and precise slash accurate representation of the Earth. We're streaming all of those data, like Bing Maps data, Azure augmentation data. We represent the entire world. So what happens if I don't have high bandwidth available? What happens if even I have no internet connection at all? This is the Seattle area in offline. And as you can see, all the buildings are there, all the water information is there, and the city is recognizable. Second here is online Paris. So the majority of buildings here are being automatically generated, and you also have the water information, and it's a more accurate version of the world. And here again, VFR flying is possible. And third here is where we have the best quality. This is the city of New York. You may have recognized it. This is when we have photogrammetry data available in Bing Maps for more than 400 cities. This is or which precise details you have on a given building. So in order to add this level of precision to Microsoft Flight Simulator, we relied on procedural generation.
Each microphone is recording specific elements or perspective. Front propeller, side propeller, closed exhaust, far exhaust, and so on. This modular approach lets us create specific audio emitters for each sonic source, bringing a true 3D audio experience. For example, if you get close to the exhaust, you will hear more of it. Following your position in game, you will never hear the same thing. More than the engine, we also carefully recorded cockpit buttons, switches, instruments, or even flaps. Last but not least, thanks to audio convolution technology, we were able to record cockpit acoustics, which allowed us to play any sounds or voices as if you actually heard it in the cockpit. For example, if you wish to create new sounds, it will allow you to play them in the acoustic space of the cockpit. Like in real life, when the sound is bouncing back to you because of the mountains around you. Attenuation, reflections, Doppler effects all together brings accuracy and give an organic feeling to the sonic source of the new Microsoft Flight Simulator. When your plane is checking, or when you're doing a far from perfect landing, you're going to hear the impact and the physical rattle of the plane. A really useful feedback to determine how successful your landing was. We also simulated the aerodynamics wind flow on the plane using wind sounds. Especially in external view, where we can have more creativity, you'll be able to hear your actual plane movements. mountainscape. For example, you will get a very different kind of fauna sound in the African savanna than in the Alaskan area. We also simulated the night and day soundscape with different ambience at night time. Let's say you increase the wind. You'll not only be able to feel the wind during your flight experience, but also hear the wind. We also have rain, thunder, and even storm for a complete weather experience. Thank you for watching this episode. And on behalf of the Flight Simulator audio team, I hope you enjoy hearing the world we created for you.